Welcome to Bible Adventure Club. My name is Antone and this is my friend.
I am Ariel.
Woohoo! We're so glad that you are joining us. We're going to start with a new series and we're going to look at men and women who were superheroes in the Bible.
Kind of.
So wait, we're kind of going to look at men and women who were heroes in the Bible?
No. We're going to look at people in the Bible who were kind of superheroes.
Oh, that makes sense now. Right. We're going to look at men and women, boys and girls, who God used as part of his plan to rescue people from sin. But we're also going to see how these people were not always so good and not always so strong and not always so brave.
They were just a picture of the one true superhero, the true hero of the Bible, the true hero of God's story. That is Jesus.
So let's all stand together and get ready to praise Jesus now.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Everyone, I didn't see you there. I was so busy enjoying our worship song. I'm so excited for today's story from the Bible. Did you know the Bible is one book that tells one big story? It's actually made of lots of different books and lots of smaller stories too. The best part is that all these stories are true. The Bible really is my favorite book in the whole world.
And it's mine too. Let's get ready for our story now. Do you have a comfy spot to sit? Are you warm? Well, in today's true story from the Bible, we're going to go all the way back to the very beginning to see how God made the first people, the first man and the first woman. And you will find this true story right at the start of your Bible in the book of Genesis. Can you all say that with me? Genesis. Great job. Now, right at the very beginning, there was nothing except God. To imagine a little bit of what this is like, I want you to close your eyes tight and keep very quiet. Well, then God made everything, and he did this only by speaking. Can you do that? Let's say chocolate. That didn't work. How about ice cream? That also didn't work. Well, only God is powerful enough to speak and make something. How awesome is He? So God just spoke and pop. There was sky and water, land and plants, the sun, the moon, and all the stars in the sky. There were animals in the sky like birds and butterflies, and there were animals on the land, crawling things and walking things, and tall things like giraffes, and long things like crocodiles, and there were also animals in the water like fish and octopus and jellyfish. And God looked at what He made and He said, "It is good." But God wasn't done yet. He saved the best part for last. God made the first people, just two, one man and one woman. The man was called Adam and the woman was called Eve. And God loved them very, very much. And they loved God very, very much. They were God's friends. God made the people to be like Him. Well, not to be exactly like Him, but to be a picture of Him. Kind of like when you look in the mirror and you see a picture of your face. When God made the first people, He said, "It is very good." So God made animals. Maybe you have a pet at home. God made them. If you are a girl, God made girls just like you. And if you are a boy, God made boys just like you. God made men and women, boys and girls. And in the next couple of stories, we will look at all kinds of men and women and boys and girls who were all used in God's great rescue plan. Now you might be wondering, His rescue plan? What did people need rescuing from? Well, that's a very good question. The very first people, Adam and Eve, lived in a perfect place and they loved God the best. But things didn't stay that way for very long. God's people, Adam and Eve, listened to His enemy, the devil, instead of listening to God. And when they disobeyed God, sin entered into the world. Adam and Eve couldn't live in the garden anymore. Sin kept them far away from God. Life would be very hard, and one day they would die. But God still loved Adam and Eve very, very much. And even though they disobeyed Him, He promised that one day they will live close to Him again. God promised to send a rescuer to fight against God's enemy, the devil, and to rescue His people from sin so that they can be God's friends again and live with Him forever. And this rescuer's name is Jesus. That's correct. But Jesus wouldn't come straight away. God had a big rescue plan, and He was going to use many other men and women to be a part of His plan. And that's what we'll be looking at in the weeks to come. Let's close our eyes and pray. Father God, thank You for making men and women and for making boys and girls like all the ones watching right now. Help us to trust You and to know that You love us all the same and that we are all important to You. Amen. I can't wait for our next stories, and I'm so glad God made pigeons like me. Can you remember how God made everything? He used crayons. He used stickers. He just spoke. That's right. God is awesome. All right. See you all next time.